What I want to do is share two slides that I think underscores why this is not a Putin issue or a pandemic issue. This is the Federal Reserve's balance sheet. Now, for those of you who don't follow monetary policy, the balance sheet simply refers to what are the assets that a central bank owns, how much do they have? And you can see that the little gray line is when the pandemic hit. So in some sense, you can say the pandemic played a big role because it was when the pandemic hit that the Fed dramatically expanded its balance sheet, which in simple terms meant that it went out to the open market and bought up lots of treasuries and mortgage-backed securities, which are the two things it tends to buy when it conducts its monetary policy. And since you're not close enough to see the numbers on the left side of the vertical axis, we basically went from a balance sheet of about $4 million. We skyrocketed up to $7 million in just a couple of months. And ever since then, it's trended up now to $9 trillion. So the Fed injected a huge amount of liquidity into the system. That's the part of the blame in Washington. What about the part of the blame in Frankfurt? Well, here's the ECB's balance sheet. And you can see that for a long time, up until, say, 2014, the balance sheet was $1 to $2 trillion. Now, the European Central Bank was different than the Fed in that they started expanding their balance sheet sooner. Was this because Draghi said we're going to do whatever it takes to keep the euro alive? What was he doing here? Was he trying to, in effect, prop up the fiscal systems of Greece and Italy and other countries? But one thing that's very clear is that once you get to the last couple of years, just like with the Fed, we saw a huge expansion of the European Central Bank's balance sheet. In this case, it went from about $4.5 trillion to about $8.5 trillion. So both central banks roughly created out of thin air $4 trillion of money. Now, let's make sure we understand. They did not create $4 trillion of economic output. They did not create $4 trillion of wealth. They took an existing economy and simply said, here's $4 trillion of extra liquidity in the system. And the purpose of this panel, I think, and I'll be very interested to hear what my other panelists say, is we have to ask why. Was it simply a fear of that the pandemic was going to cause an economic cataclysm? I mean, back in March of 2020, lots of my friends were going out and stocking up on jars of peanut butter and cans of tuna fish. You know, people didn't know whether the world was basically coming to an end and you'd have tens of millions of people dying. And so, okay, I'll give them a free pass. Central bankers back then were panicking just like everyone else. And there definitely was a big short-run hiccup in the global economy at the time. The problem is, once we got to the summer of 2020, it was obvious that we were going to sort of be able to ride this out, even if the vaccines hadn't been developed. Why did the central banks continue dumping more and more money into the system? So pandemic panic maybe explains the start. You know, maybe they thought it was like some giant balance sheet recession like 2008 was going to happen because of coronavirus. But once we got again to middle of 2020, you have to wonder, and I put a question mark here because I don't know the answer, but to what extent maybe did central bankers decide that, okay, it's fun to create money, and if we create more money, that means we can buy up all the dodgy debt of Italy and Greece and other countries that otherwise would have a lot of trouble, would probably face a Greek-style fiscal crisis if they had to actually rely on private investors to buy up their debt, which of course means they would have looked at the those governments' fiscal positions and said, wait, we don't trust that they're going to pay us back. But governments don't have to face that problem if they have a central bank to buy up all their additional debt. And I think that's the fundamental challenge that that a lot of the world faces right now is as we unwind, at least if we do unwind, these balance sheet, what was it? Warren Buffett said, when the tide goes out, you see he's swimming naked. And I don't think the problem in the U.S. is as severe as the problem in Europe, because I do think that countries like Greece and Italy have been swimming naked.